This week we're going to take a look at Turtle Talk. I'm with Skip Hager, the program coordinator of the Turtle Patrol. So Skip, what is the Turtle Patrol?
The Turtle Patrol is a group of volunteers that operate here on the island. We operate under the direction of the North Carolina Wildlife Resources Commission Sea Turtle Project. We ride the beach in the mornings looking for nests that turtles have come in during the night. We'll take those nests that we find, we'll mark them, sometimes we relocate them, and we'll monitor those nests until the nests hatch, you know, usually 50 to 60 days later. After that, the nests are closed out and we try and return the dunes and the beach to the original position we found them.
Now I know on Wednesdays you have Turtle Talk. Can you tell us a little bit about Turtle Talk?
Turtle Talk is our public education program. We hold it every Wednesday during the summer, normally from Memorial Day through, starting next year, through Labor Day. This year, our last one will be on the 18th of August. We have displays of showing the various turtles that come here, what a nest looks like, how we go about doing our daily task on the beach, how we bring the turtles in. It's very popular with the local visitors, and the town hall is usually standing room only when they come in.
So how many nests do we have this year?
This year we've had so far 30 nests. The nesting season should run for another week to 2 weeks. Of those 30 nests, 5 of them have already hatched, and we're just waiting for the rest of them.
I know one of the big problems you guys have is people leaving cabanas or digging big holes on the beach.
This is kind of a hot button with some people, others no. Cabanas, umbrellas, all the other things laying on the beach, these are things that a turtle could run into when they come on the beach. A turtle, like any other wild thing, they get them out of their normal environment and they're very skittish. So a female coming on the beach, she could run into one of these cabanas, it could scare her, she'd turn around and go back in the water. Holes are something else. I don't know why people come to the beach and dig holes, but they dig very, very big ones. The very large ones and shallow ones are not that much of a problem. It's the deep, steep-sided ones that a turtle could fall into and couldn't get out. The others, you can pretty much crawl out. The holes are more of a hazard to the people on the beach than anything else. We've had several over the years where people have stepped in these things, broken ankles, legs, skinned up knees, all the rest. So fill in your holes.
Is there anything else we should know about Turtle Patrol or Turtle Talk?
Well, this year we've had a very rare visitor on the beach with a leatherback turtle. In the past 20 years, I think, there have only been 8 successful nests in the entire state of North Carolina. So we're quite happy to have that. Hopefully the nest will be hatching out here in the next week or so, and we'll see how successful it's going to be.
Is there a website we can get all this information at?
Our website is www.hbturtletalk.org.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Can never be seen, more to do than can ever.